All right, Shalom, Yasharala, back at it again with another Lord-Wedded Edifying video. Through the spirit and the power of Yahweh, Bahashim, Yahweh Shah, Bahashim, Rachakodash. Before I go any further, I want to give all honor and all glory and all praises to our Heavenly Father and to His only begotten Son, Yahweh, Bahashim, Yahweh Shah, Bahashim, Rachakodash. And next up, double honors to our apostles and our elders, the Great Millstone, the Store Guardians of the Highways and Byways, and feed us with the 100% true, according to the Bible, and Heruel, and Shalom, Lavachorium, Wabarakium, Shayasharala, which is peace and blessings to the elect of the nation of Israel, and Ashwan Kodash, the Hebrew tongue. And pretty much the name of this lesson is going to be called Recompense is Coming, man. You see, payback is coming upon Esau, Edom, first and foremost, the other heathen nation, so even on the 2/3 of our own people, man, you know, because they're wicked, man, you know, but mainly going to focus on these other heathen nations. But the first scripture I want to start off with, since I mentioned the 2/3, right, let me bring out a scripture about vengeance on them. This is the book of one of my favorites, actually, 2 Thessalonians chapter 1 verse 7. And it reads, and to you who are troubled, rest with us. Exactly. See, now who is troubled on this side right here? The elect, the men of the Lord. Starting off with the head apostles and the elders on down, which we're hoping to be of the elect. You know, we're troubled, man. Who we are troubled by? First and foremost, we're troubled by the wicked, which is Esau, Edom, and these other heathen nations. And we're also troubled on the 2/3 of our people, because they're the ones that mainly scoffing, scorn. You know what I'm saying? On the comment boards, man. Or out there on the highways and hedges. And it says, rest with us. Right? You find rest. You find comfort in these scriptures. And it's true. And it reads, when the Lord Yahweh shall be revealed from heaven with his mighty angels, right? When he returns. Verse 8. In flaming fire, taking vengeance on them who know not the Most High. Exactly. See? First and foremost, you know, that's talking about the 2/3 of our people, man. The one who is the Lord's chosen people, who's supposed to know the Lord, you see, but they refuse to do what the Lord requires them to do. So the Lord's going to start off with the sanctuary, you know what I'm saying, the house of Israel first, you know, the Israelites who know they're Israelites, you see, on down to the regular 2/3, on down to the other nations as well, right? And it says, and they obey not the gospel, which mean the good news, which is this truth. You know, which is the law, statutes, the commandments of the scriptures. And our Lord, Yahweh Shah HaMashiach. See, mainly focusing on the 2/3. Verse 9, who shall be punished with everlasting destruction from the presence of the Lord and from the glory of his power. Exactly, see. You'll get zapped by the laser beams from the chariots with the word going to cause UFOs. And you're going to be destroyed by those missiles, man. You know, referring to the 2/3 of our people, the Lord's coming back with vengeance, man. You know, upon the 2/3 of our people, because it was the 2/3 of our people that sold the Lord out, man. You see? They said, crucify him, crucify him. Give us Barabbas, man. They also said, we have no king but Caesar, man. So they chose, you know, Esau, Edom, and the 2/3 nigga over the Lord, man. You see? So the Lord's going to come back and take a vengeance upon 2/3 of our people, man. You know? So now let's get on you heathen nations, right? Now let's get on some payback, some recompense upon you heathens, man. You nations that are outside of the nation of Israel. This is the book of Revelation chapter 13, verse 9. If any man have an ear, let him hear. This is the spiritual ears, man. Meaning if you can understand it, you know, hey, listen up. And it reads, verse 10, he that leadeth into captivity shall go into captivity. Now, captivity is another word for slavery, man. Now, it's obvious and evident in historical facts that the so-called white man, you know, had us in slavery, that the Ishmaelites, which are the so-called Arabs, had us in slavery, that the East Indians had us in slavery, that the Hamites, the so-called Africans, which were not, had us in slavery, you know, so on and so forth, man. So he that leadeth in the captivity shall go into captivity. They're going to go into slavery as well. He that killeth with the sword must be killed with the sword. Exactly, see? And listen, man, the sword is any killing instrument. You know, back then it was literal swords. And now it's just any, it's this man's technology. It's the Maxine. You see what I'm saying? So any killing instrument that they kill us with, they're gonna be killed. They're gonna be killed as well, man. When we get our spiritual powers, you know, according to the Bible, and it reads, "Here's the patience and the faith of the saints." Now, patience go back to suffering, awaiting, awaiting while suffering, man. You see, and it's our faith. Faith is this evidence of things hoped for. This is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. You see, so it's an understanding of things that you can't see, you know, and a firm belief in it. So now, as a matter of fact, let's get numbers, right? Let's get numbers. Because payback is coming upon you, you heathen nations as well, man. I started off with the 2/3. Now it's on you heathens. This is the book of Numbers 35 and 33. "Ye shall not pollute the land wherein ye are, for blood it defileth the land." Right. See, now whose blood defiles this land right here? You know, the Israelites, man. You know, starting off with the Northern Kingdom, you know, the Gadites, the Reubenites, the Issacharites, you know what I mean? The Northern Kingdom, you see, then they brought us over here, you know what I'm saying? Majority of Southern Kingdom, you know, from the west coast of Africa, you know, and over here in slavery, man, to serve slavery, man, you know, and they did all type of horrific and abominable things to our people, man, you know. And it reads, "And the land cannot be cleansed of the blood that is shed therein, but by the blood of him that shed it." Exactly, see? So payback is coming, man. First and foremost to you Edomites, you so-called white people, on down, man. You see? So listen, man. You can't cleanse the blood of that's just been shed here except shed the blood of him that did it, man. You see? So that's payback, man. You know? And there ain't nothing that you can do about it because the Lord said so, you know? This is the book of Exodus 21, verse 26. This is the Exodus 21 and 16. "He that stealeth a man, stealeth," go back to kidnap, man. You know? Because they got the power and authority from the Lord to do so. "And selleth him," right? We were sold in them auction blocks, right? You know, that's where you get that Black Friday cheap sales thing come from, you know? "Or if he be found in his hand," right? See, we're still finding this devil's hand, man. You see? He wouldn't let us go. "He shall surely be put to death." And hey, listen, man, and you best believe the Lord's gonna bring judgment upon Esau, Edom, first and foremost. They're gonna get the worst judgment out of all the heathen nations. They're gonna be exterminated after their 1,000 years of slavery, man. According to Obadiah, the 18th verse, you know. So payback is coming, man. You know, upon the 2/3 of our people, first and foremost. As a matter of fact, let's get another scripture about the 2/3 of our people, right? We're gonna kind of DJ it. This is the book of Ezekiel, chapter 9, verse 4. And it reads, "And the Lord said unto him," the Lord is talking to the angel, right? "Go through the midst of the city, through the midst of Jerusalem." Now, Jerusalem is a people before it's a place. Like 2 Maccabees 5 and 19 says, man. You know? As a matter of fact, let me get that right fast. This is the book of 2 Maccabees, chapter 5, verse 19. "Nevertheless, the Most High did not choose the people for the place's sake, but the place for the people's sake." Exactly. See, so wherever, you know, the people, you know what I'm saying, are at, majority of the people are at, you know what I'm saying, that's where the land is, man, so to speak. You know, like the majority of our people are in America, so this would be spiritual Jerusalem, you know? So this is going back to the Ezekiel 9 and 4, "And the Lord said unto him, go through the midst of the city, through the midst of Jerusalem, and set a mark upon the forehead of the men that sigh and that cry for all the abominations that be done in the midst thereof." Now, abomination is a wicked, filthy act, man, you know? And we definitely start off with the head apostles, elders are down, are sighing and crying to the Lord and putting curses upon these people for all the wicked acts that they do, you know? And that mark right there go back to the Hebrew word thawab, which meaning a spiritual mark that goes back to exempt from judgment, man. That's going to be put upon the elect, which we're hoping to be, You know? And it reads, and to the others, he said of mine hearing. Exactly. See, those of the two-thirds, those at this in this time right here, during the time of Ezekiel, who was idol worshiping, right? And they're doing the same thing in these times. He said in mine hearing, go ye after him through the city and smite. Exactly. See? So just like how he's going to deliver and set a spiritual mark upon the elect, he's gonna put a mark upon the two-thirds, which they're gonna have that mark of the beast. You know what I'm saying? They're gonna be destroyed, man, by the Lord. And it reads, and let not your eyes spare, neither have ye pity. See, don't have no mercy upon them, man. Verse 6, slay utterly old and young, both maids and little children. Now maids are young women, and these little monsters, they gonna get it too, man. But they ain't got no type of respect, they ain't got no type of order, because they've been raised by their wicked mothers, man. And it reads, and women. So women and women are mentioned here twice, both young and old. But come not near any man upon whom is the mark, which is the elect, and begin at my sanctuary. See, that's the point, man. Those who know that they're Israelites, man, you know. And then begin at the ancient men which were before the house. See, so this is going into these false teachers and leaders, man. You see, the judgment is going to begin at the leaders, then it's going to trickle down to the followers, man. You see, Yahweh Bashim HaShah is going to put judgment upon our people. You know, he's going to bring revenge, man. You know? So now, let's go to the book of, as a matter of fact, let me see. Yeah, Khan. So yeah, that's about it through the spirit of Yahweh Bashim HaShah. Lord will edify until next time I say Shalom.